Hi everyone, my name is Pratap. I think I already have spoken to you a little bit about myself over the phone, and few of them, those have not heard about me. Just to give a small introduction about me, and this batch what I'm going to start is the 101st batch what I'm going to start now. Until now I have taught 100 batches, and that is about my training experience. When we come to work experience, I have around 7 years of experience into this automation as well, and around more than 6 years of experience I have into this automation using Selenium. That's about me. And coming to the course, what we are going to learn here, we are going to learn end-to-end course in Selenium, whatever you need to work with Selenium, and what are the prerequisites you know need to learn with Selenium. Everything I will be guiding from end to end part here. Even if you are new to programming, or else if you don't know anything about programming, also no need to worry. I will be teaching end to end part from today onwards. Each and every class, whatever I teach you today, some homeworks will be there again. And I am recording this class. I will be giving the video of this class also to you once you are once you finish up this class. Each and every class, I will be recording the class, and I will be giving the video of this class also to you. Every day, as I said, there will be 1.5 hour of class will be there. This will continue for almost 30 days minimum to 40 days max. What we will be taking 40 hours is the class. What it is required to learn the Selenium. 40 hours is must and required. And at the end of the course, I will be making you to work on real-time projects as well. What it is must and required. If you want to learn that real-time project, for sure you should be aware with the previous topics, whatever I am going to teach you. If you are not practicing, for sure you will not understand the real-time project at the end. That's why whatever the practice I give here to do and submit it to me, please try to do that and submit it to me. First 1 or 2 days of classes, there will not be much, because we will be seeing some basic introduction. And there will not be any theory part at all here. Only today's class will be the last theory class what you will be learning. Just introduction. For sure you will not have any theory going further. Don't expect much theory, because there is nothing to learn. Theory you can get it anywhere from Google and you can learn it. But practical part, that is not difficult. That is not that easy to get from Google. Okay. No need to search anything through Google also. I will give you some part of theory what you need to learn. That is more than sufficient to learn Selenium. If you are not aware with manual, no need to worry. I will be teaching you the manual concepts also, but not in these sessions. I will take a separate sessions for that, and I will teach you if you are not aware with manual. Those who are already working in manual, it's not a problem. You can just continue only these classes. That is more than sufficient for you. That is all about our class. Do you have any doubts before starting our classes for what we need to learn or something about this? Yeah. Yes, Java is required. For sure, I will teach you the Java concepts also. I have a course content what I will be giving you. Might be tomorrow or day after tomorrow, I will give you the course content what you will be learning. You can take down the course content at the time, and so that you will come out of all those doubts. This is the course content. Day 1, what we are going to learn. Day 2, what we are going to learn. Those 38 classes. This is one extra class. And this is one more extra class what I have. Totally 38 classes it will consume. On an average, this is divided based on 1.5 hour of basis, each and every topic. Okay, so few topics I will complete in half an hour itself. Few topics it will take 2 or 3 days also. On an average, it will be 1.5 hour of basis. 36 classes it will take to finish up. In between, if I get 1 or 2 updated topics in Selenium, it might be 1 or 2 days extra also. Sometimes for at least 5 batches in once, there will be one new topic which will get added, and some old topics which will get removed. Selenium is something which gets updated every 15 days. Every 15 days you will see updates on this. You have to be up to date always. At the end of the class, even I will let you know where should you get updates time to time, and how to get updated always. How to work on the updated topics always. Next, any other doubts what you have? No? Shall we step in? Next. Before going into automation, first and foremost, let us see what is meant by testing. First, let us see what is meant by testing first of all. What is testing?
What is testing? You guys are, few of them are already working in testing, right? I think few guys are more experienced than me in manual testing, because I don't have much exposure to manual testing, to be honest. I have only this teaching experience of around some 50 batches of manual testing. After that, I have stopped manual testing also, teaching manual testing even. Okay, good. Good. Any other definitions for testing? To check the quality of the product. How will you check? By validating again. See, there is something called actual and there is something called expected. You will compare both. You will compare both. If both are same, it's pass, or else it's fail. That's to be simple to test an application. For example, I have a car. There is something called the design should be like this and it should work with certain functionalities. If that is met, expected, if that is what expected and the actual is what we have got, then if both are same, then it is pass. Or else, if there are three wheels to the car, then of course it's not a car at all, first of all, it's an auto. Right? Then requirements is not matching. That is simple to be as a, what we come to tell as testing. For example, earlier days, in the year before 1998, people used to test this manually. People used to test this manually. I mean, for example, if I have a product called Gmail, if I want to test the product Gmail, there are many modules in Gmail, right? Like inbox module, outbox module, drafts, send mail, a lot of modules will be there. Each and every module will have different test cases again. Each and every module will contain some 100 test cases. On an overall, imagine that there are 1,000 test cases for that Gmail product. On an average, how many test cases can an employee test per day? If it is a full functional test cases like that. As per industrial standards, an employee can test 30 to 35 test cases per day, not beyond that. Harish, please mute your mic, Harish. Sorry, Ravi. Please mute your mic. Okay. An employee can test 30 to 35 test cases per day. In that case, how many employees are required to test the Gmail product if there are 1,000 test cases? One day, within one day, we have to test. 30 to 35 employees are required, 33, not exactly, we cannot calculate. 30 to 35 test cases, 30 to 35 employees are required to test the Gmail product. If the, for sure, we know that the Gmail product will withstand for again at least some 20 years or 30 years. In that case, there will be some or the other updates which keeps on happening for the Gmail product. In that case, they have to hire the 30 to 40 employees for next some 20 to 30 years. Whenever there is updates, they want to keep on testing that application. Am I correct what I'm telling? In the, for example, earlier, before the year 2000, they used to hire these 30 to 40 employees and they want to do that. Nowadays, what they have did is, they will automate those 1,000 test cases in the span of 6 months. They'll automate these 1,000 test cases. They'll automate these 1,000 test cases and only one employee is enough. Only one employee is enough to maintain those 1,000 test cases. They can remove the remaining 29 employees if they have 30 employees. How to automate that? What is the purpose of automation? That is what we are going to see. We are not going to see anything about manual here. We are going to see completely about automation. How to write the automation test cases? If you run that, what is the output of that? Why those 29 employees are not, those are the things what we are going to see now. Okay. What is automation, what you know as of now? What is meant by automation, first of all? You should have, before coming, you would have learned some general things. Repetitive test cases, yes. How it happens? Without any manual effort? How can we do that? We'll be writing some piece of code. If you run that code, automatically system itself will do that. How to write that code, that is what we are going to see here. If I want to open a browser, earlier days we used to click on this manually. Now there is some piece of code. If I write that code, and if I run that code, automatically it will open the browser. If I want to open the URL, I need to go and type the URL. I don't want to type that. I have a piece of code. To open the browser, I will be using a code, something called WebDriver driver equal to new Firefox driver. And if I run that line of code, right, automatically it will open the browser. To open the URL, I will be using a line of code called driver.get, and I will pass this URL to that line. Automatically, if I run that line, it will open the URL. There are some different techniques. How can I do that? That is what we are going to learn here through automation. And what is the output of, what is the benefit of that? What is the benefit of learning automation? It reduces manual effort and a lot of time consuming as well. For example, if I want to test those, right, at least they will take the whole day to test that 1,000 test cases. But if I automate that, I can finish in 1 hour. I can make that 1,000 test cases to run in 10 different machines. Yes. Your name? Pauline. Yeah, come on. See, if I automate that, lot of time is saved here for me. Lot of time is saved. Stephen, can you mute your mic, Stephen? Sorry, not mute. Can you switch off your video? Strike off your video, Stephen. Okay. Now, we are learning about advantages of automation, right? It reduces manual effort, it reduces time. Of course, these are the two factors what normally companies will be looking for. If you do that, of course, which means that we are enough about automation. That is enough for automation. How can we achieve that? That is okay. Before going to that, what are the tools what you know in automation? First, in testing, we are going to know about automation. Your name? Chaitanya. I forgot. Sorry. I think that's it. Lost. Automation. What are the tools what you know in automation? Good, Selenium, QTP, any other tools what you know? Good. I have worked on Test Complete as well. I have enough experience in Test Complete also. Any other? LoadRunner is not an automation tool, it's a performance testing tool. We are talking about automation tools here. Tosca. There is a tool called Renorex. I have worked on this tool also. There is a tool called Rational Robot by IBM. Robot by IBM. There is a tool called Words by Oracle. There are tens of tools available in the market. If you keep on searching, right, there are tens of tools available in the market. Not hundreds, we can count in tens. But out of these, even if you ask the existing automation engineer also, he will tell only about these two tools only, Selenium and QTP. No one will talk about the other tools because the other tools are rarely used in the market. Rarely used in the market. Those tools are not much used. Okay. Because few companies, what they do, they develop their own tools. Like IBM, they have developed the Rational Robot. They won't outsource it to some companies. Sonata Software has their own tool. They won't even tell the name of the tool what they are using. They just develop the tool and they will use for themselves. That tool meets the requirements of their automation. That is why they won't outsource it to some other companies also. But Selenium and QTP, they have outsourced it to the market, and most of the companies they use this. QTP is the first company who has invented the strategy called automation. QTP is developed by the company called HP. They're the first masters. Like, for example, now C is the one who have invented the programming language initially. They used to tell like that, right? Then C++ has copied that. Then after that, after C++, Java came, Python, like these different languages came. In the same way, QTP is the master who have invented the tool called automation, first of all. Earlier, they don't know what is meant by automation itself. Okay, next. In the year 1998, they have invented, and in the year 2000, they have released, officially they have released into the market. Okay. But in the year 2004, only Selenium guys have introduced, and the company which has invented the Selenium is ThoughtWorks. We can see in detail about this later. ThoughtWorks is the company who has invented this Selenium, first of all. Okay. Now, when we take the statistics of around, just a minute, guys. Got stuck. These are the different tools available in the market. These are the different tools available in the market. If you want, you can take down this also. Selenium, QTP, this. Now, let me see a general topic of statistics of tools used in the market. Drawing might be poor. When we take the year 2004 to 2005, the percentage of usage of tools in the market, 70% of the companies are using QTP at that time. 70% of the companies are using QTP at the time. 20% of the companies are using Selenium, and 10% of the companies are using other tools. Other tools in the year 2004 to 2005. But when we take the current statistics, right, that is 2016 to 17 is the current statistics what we have. What happened now is 70% of the companies are using Selenium nowadays. I hope you know that most of the companies are using Selenium, but you don't know the percentage and statistics, right? This is the current statistics what we have. And 20% of the companies are using QTP now, and 10% of the companies are using other tools. 10% of the companies are using other tools. Why this drastic change has been happened in this span of 10 to 12 years itself? What is the reason? What is the necessity of everyone migrating from QTP to Selenium? We came to know that there is a tough competition between these two tools only. The other tools, they are not at all competitors for other tools. They are independent of each other. Okay, why this drastic change has been happened in the span of 8 to 10 years itself? It's an open source tool. See, let us see. Now what we are going to see is difference between QTP and Selenium. We can see the difference between QTP and Selenium. When we go to the interview, right, as I said, throughout this course, I will be giving some list of 45 interview questions for you. Those who have attended the previous batch, I think you have got the interview questions already. I will be giving the interview questions also. Start taking down the interview questions from now on. Last 3 or 4 pages of your notebook, allocate for interview questions. Take down the first question. You will be learning one question today. What is the difference between QTP and Selenium? They might ask in the interview. What is the difference between QTP and Selenium? You will end up with some around 50 questions like that by the last day of the class. What is the difference between Selenium and QTP? Let us see the answer now. See, there is a tough competition between this QTP and Selenium. That is what we came to know. Let us see the differences between selenium and QTP. Selenium and QTP. What are the, see, once you go to the interview, they will ask, what is the difference between selenium and QTP? Apart from open source and paid, even people become smart nowadays, right? That is the only answer what everyone will be telling. That's why they, when they ask the question itself, they will give you that answer and they will ask you that. Most of the interviews, I have got this answer from the students, those who have attended earlier. They're asking questions like this. What is the difference between QTP and Selenium apart from open source tool? Okay, as you said, this Selenium is an open source tool and this QTP is a paid tool. What is the difference between open source and paid? Free for license, yes. Don't tell that I can download it for free of cost. Downloading, anyone can download. While you are about to use that, that matters again. Right? While you are installing this QTP, at the last step of installation, it asks a 16-digit product key. 16-digit or 20-digit product key. If you want to purchase the product key, right, again you want to pay some money to the HP guys and you want to get that. Whereas, while you are installing Selenium, it won't ask you any product key at all. Where you get it for free of cost and use it for free of cost. Are you getting this? Whereas QTP, if you want to use QTP, right, you want to pay 32,000 for one system for 1 year. That is, the prices has been slashed down now. Earlier it is 120,000 for one system for 1 year, that too. That is why people has stopped using the QTP and slowly migrated to Selenium. For each and every employee, they have to spend some 35,000 per year. Again, if you want to renew that every year, they have to keep on renewing that. They have to pay some 30,000 like that and renew it. Where else I get it for free of cost here? Any other difference what you know between Selenium and QTP? Yes, that is a disadvantage. Let us see about advantages first. Later on, we can see about the disadvantages. Advantages of Selenium over QTP. Good, very good. This Selenium supports all the major browsers. This, don't take down any notes. I will give you time to take down because I will alter all these things again. It supports all the major browsers. All the major browsers. Whereas this QTP supports only Internet Explorer, IE. It supports only IE browser. The latest version of QTP is supporting Mozilla and Chrome also. Again, if you want to work with Mozilla and Chrome, you want to buy a separate plugins. Again, it costs 6,000 per plugin. For each and every step, you have to keep on paying in that to work with different functionalities. Right, where else? The Selenium, it supports almost all the major browsers it supports. Like Mozilla, Chrome, IE, Safari, Opera, Ghost browser, Edge browser, GeekoDrive, all those browsers it supports. Major browsers. Any other difference what you know? When we talk about the compatibility, what about, why can't we say about operating systems? This Selenium supports all the operating systems. All the operating systems. Where else this QTP supports only Windows. It doesn't support Mac machines and Linux machines. Again, if you want, most of the US based culture, they use Mac machines and Linux machines, right? When compared with Windows, the majority of usage is for Mac machines and Linux machines there. Even nowadays, everyone are moving to cloud, right? They select Linux machines by default, where they get it for free of cost and they can use it. Again, an advantage for us, right? Any other difference? Good. Scripting languages again. This, if you know Java, you can start writing the Selenium code. Or else if you know Python, you can start writing the Selenium code. Or else if you know Ruby, you can start writing the Selenium code. Or else if you know C Sharp, you can start writing the Selenium code. If you know Perl, you can start writing the Selenium code. The Selenium supports multiple languages. Selenium supports multiple languages. Don't take down, I'll give you time. Listen. Where else, if you want to work with QTP, must ensure you should know VB scripting. Or else you cannot work with QTP. You should learn VB scripting, then you want to learn the QTP. This doesn't support any other language. In college curriculum, you would have come across at least one of these languages if you are with IT background. either Java, C sharp, Python or some other language, right? Few university supports few. Where else it will be very easy for us to learn this Selenium. Where else to work with QTP, again you want to learn complete from scratch onwards, you have to learn this VB scripting, again you want to start working with QTP. That's the problem again here. Next. The size of the software is just 28 MB, whereas the size of the software is 1.5 GB. If you want to work with Selenium, if you have old Pentium 1 machines which has 256 MB of RAM and old machines, in those also you can install the Selenium and you can work with that. Whereas if you want to work with QTP, right, at least you should have 2 GB of RAM to load your QTP software and to work with the QTP software. Are you getting this? See, let us pass this for some time, difference between QTP and Selenium for some time. I am going to teach you one general topic, later on we can come back to this, that is required to learn the next point. Okay, let us pass this for some time, we can resume back to that later. Now I have a website here. I have a website called abc.com. It has username text box. It has username text box. It has password box. And I have to click on login button. This is just a login screen what I have. If you want to manually verify whether login is working fine or not, how will you verify whether manually the login is working fine or not? And where will you enter the username and password? How will you get that first of all? Before that you need to open the URL, right? Where will you open the URL? Before that you need to open the browser, right? Let us go in a procedure way. First I need to open the browser. Then I need to open the URL called abc.com. Then enter the username. Where will you enter the username? In the username text box. Enter the password. Where? In the password box. Enter the username in the username text box. Enter the password in the password box. Then click on login button so that I can verify login is working fine. That is through manually I will do like that. In the same way through automation also, first you have to open the browser, open the URL, enter the username in the username text box. When you are going to enter the username in the username text box, identify the username text box first, then perform some typing operation in that. Okay, then identify the password box and perform some typing operation in the password box. Identify the login button and perform some click operation. Are you getting this? What I'm telling? See, to do any automation activity, you will be following only two steps. One is identifying the element. Second point is performing action on it. These are the only two steps. For example, if I have a checkbox here, in this corner, I have a checkbox. If I want to click on the checkbox, what I will be doing? Identify the element, perform action on that element. Are you getting this? If you have a link, forget your password link here. If you want to click on that link, identify this element, perform action. To do anything, if you have a radio button, If you want to click on the radio button, identify the element and perform action on that element. For next 40 hours, whatever you are going to learn, right, it will be only these two steps what you are going to learn. Only these two steps what you are going to learn. Apart from that, you are not going to learn any other thing. Apart from that, you are not going to learn any other. Only two steps you are going to learn for next 40 hours. This has that much weightage. Okay. See, to identify the elements, we are going to use something called element locators. We are going to use something called element locators, a technique called element locators to identify the element. What is the purpose of element locators? To identify the element. Element locators are used to identify the element. Until unless we identify the element, we cannot perform action on that element. Are you getting this? To do automation, those two steps are necessary. Take down this rough work, whatever I have written. This is necessary. These two points are most required for you. Automation, to do automation, first you need to identify the element, then you want to perform action on that element. We are going to use element locators to identify the element. To do any automation activity, we will follow only these two steps: identify the element and perform action on that element. Now, let us come back to this difference between Selenium and QDP again. In Selenium, there are 8 element locators to identify the element. 8 element locators are there. You know what is the purpose of element locators, right? To identify the element. Where else in QDP we have only one element locator? If this one element locator fails to identify any element, right? That's all. We cannot automate the test case. Hence, where else in Selenium we have different options. There are 8 element locators called ID, name, link text, expert, CSS selector, class name, tag name, and partial link text. You will learn about that from tomorrow's class onwards. That is our job. First, we will identify that element. If one element locator doesn't work, we can go with next, or else with next. There is an element locator called XPath. By using XPath, you can identify any element in a web page. But to learn XPath, at least we should spend 3 to 4 days to learn that completely. Okay, lot of weightage falls in that. Or Selenium weightage falls in XPath. If you are properly able to identify the elements, right, performing action is very easy. That is why what we are going to learn for next 4 or 5 more days, we will learn how to identify the elements. Then what we will be doing is, then we will learn some Java topics, then we will go for performing action on that element by using Java code. That is the procedure. Normally what happens, right, initially, if you learn the entire Java, again when you are starting identifying the elements, you will forget about the Java topics. Then there will not be any correlation at all, whatever you are learning. But we are going to do in a different way here. First, we can learn how to identify the elements. Keep on practicing that. Parallelly, we can learn Java. Then we can start performing the action on that. Right. These are the advantages of Selenium over QTP. Advantages of Selenium over QTP. I buy it for free of cost, right? Still, I have more advantages of using this Selenium than using QTP. But still, there are some disadvantages of using Selenium also. That is why still some 20% of the companies are still using. Or else that also has vanished into the market, right? But why that 20% of the companies are still using that? What is the reason behind it? Why they are using? Windows-based applications, fine. This Selenium supports only web applications, whereas this QTP supports both desktop and web applications. Desktop and web applications. The Selenium supports web applications and QTPs. What is web applications and what is desktop application? Can you give some examples for web applications? Examples for web application. All means what? Any the names of websites. Gmail, Facebook, Flipkart, Amazon. All these are websites, right? These are web applications. What is desktop applications? Can you give some examples for web applications? Sorry, desktop applications. Skype, VLC Media Player, this Excel sheet, WordPad, Notepad, all these things are desktop applications. If they are developing such a kind of applications, we cannot automate those by using Selenium. But nowadays, all the applications are web applications because everyone are moving to cloud nowadays. It becomes, everything is becoming a web application. It has been enough building the desktop applications. There are no further more, there are nothing much to develop on that. That's been, most of the R&D has been stopped to desktop applications. They are into web applications nowadays. Okay. This Selenium supports only web applications. It doesn't support, this is one of the drawback with Selenium, but this drawback is there from past. Don't take down, I'll give you time. Listen. This drawback is there from before some 8 months. Now what the Selenium guys are doing is they are inventing a new tool called Vinium. This Vinium is an open source tool again. This is used to automate Windows-based desktop applications. But this officially they have not released into the market yet. They might release it. Now beta versions are going on. With beta versions, no company cannot work because they might stop it suddenly also. Okay, that's why we are waiting to have an official version of this. Once this get released into the market, right, this difference also will get back. This is a drawback as of now, but in future that might get removed. Are you understanding this differences what I am telling? This is the only last theory class what I am telling, and some general topics about our Selenium what we are going to learn. Okay, now once this comes into the market, this, as I said, this will get vanished again. There is no much difference because by using see, if you learn Selenium, Vinium is very easy to learn. Only identifying the elements will vary. Performing action remains same again there. Identifying the elements you are going to learn only for 5 or 6 days here. The remaining 35 days you are going to learn completely on performing action only. Only that 5 days of class will vary if you want to learn Vinium. That you can learn it by yourself and you can start automating the desktop applications also. Are you getting this? Now, this is one drawback. One more drawback is, see, any tool, whatever you learn, initially you will start with record and playback, something called record and playback. You will record the manual test cases and play the same manual test case. You will not write the code initially. Slowly you will jump into the coding. That is the initial practice what they will be doing. But in real time in companies, you won't do like that. Directly you will be starting doing the coding itself. The Selenium, if you record through Selenium, right, it does not record properly. Whereas this QTP, it records properly. Are you getting this? What is this record and playback? We are going to see in the next coming chapter. First step, we are going to learn record and playback. When I am recording using Selenium, right, I am recording a web application. In between, there is a file upload button. If I click on that file upload button, a button from a Windows pop-up will appear. I need to select a file. But Selenium will not interact with Windows again. That's a problem. There it won't record properly. There are several situations like that. That is why Selenium won't record properly. That we will see in detail about what is record and playback in the upcoming chapter. Okay. That's all about the difference between Selenium and QTP. Take down these points. First, initial today and tomorrow we'll see only 1 hour and 1.5 hour. From Friday onwards, we will start with 1.5 hour of class. Just to have an introduction, I've called you today and tomorrow. tomorrow remind me, I will give you the contents also, what we are going to learn, because tomorrow we'll be joining tomorrow. Yes, yes, that is must and sure. You should learn that. If you are learning Selenium, it is waste of learning that without Selenium. Working with Excel data, on complete day you will look into that. Data-driven framework. Database connection, if you learn this right, it is dead easy to learn that. Okay, I will guide you how to do that also. I will just give you the guidance, you can try. If you are unable to do that, bring it to me. I will do it and I will give it. Earlier I used to teach the database connectivity only, but since it is very easy, I can finish in 10 minutes. And I am giving this Excel sheet to as a homework for them. What people felt is, if I better teach Excel sheet and if they can learn database, it is easy for them. That's why I converted before 20 batches. SQL is also there, yes. Or else you can use AutoIT. There are many tools to work. We can integrate that with Selenium and use that. Yeah, if you want, earlier I used to teach that, but just before 4 or 5 batches only I have stopped AutoIT because no one is asking that in any interviews. Or no companies will encourage you to use third-party tools. That is a third-party tool again. That's why I have stopped it. If you want, I will teach. It's a matter of half an hour, not beyond that. I will teach you that also, AutoIT. We can see, in last batch also one guy had asked. That's why we can cover in this batch. I will add that also here. Done, everyone? Yes. Prasanna, have you completed? If you are not done, just let me know during the classes 1 minute so that I can give you. Going further, I will be giving lot of programs to take down. Every day we will be seeing programs only here. Okay. These two are drawbacks, but not much. Because the first one, there is an alternative which is coming. The second one, in real time, they won't use at all. Now, let us see about Selenium. What is this Selenium? Selenium is invented in the year 2004 by a scientist called Jason Huggins. He is the one who have invented this Selenium, and the company which has invented this Selenium is ThoughtWorks. Do you know where this ThoughtWorks is located? Very near to that, Kovarmangala, Bangalore. But this is the development office what we have. Head office is in UK. London. That is where they have developed this Selenium. Selenium comprises of three components. Selenium comprises of three components. That is Selenium IDE, RC, and WebDriver. Take down this. IDE is nothing but Integrated Development Environment. RC is nothing but Remote Control . Next one is WebDriver.
WebDriver.
Okay. in the year 2004, they have implemented this Selenium IDE. They have implemented this Selenium IDE. And they have found some drawbacks with Selenium IDE. Later on, they have went to Selenium RC in the year 2007. Again, they have found some drawbacks with RC in the year 2008 and the end of year 2007, at the beginning of 2008, they have implemented Selenium WebDriver, where everyone are using Selenium WebDriver even now also. Okay, that is the updated. But if you go to Selenium videos and if you watch through Selenium videos, right, how to learn Selenium by yourself, you will see a lot of videos on Selenium IDE. It is waste of learning Selenium IDE. No use of learning Selenium IDE, because in real time they won't use that at all. Even RC, they no one uses. Very rare companies, those who are not updated properly, those they are using, it is waste of learning those two. But tomorrow what we are going to do is, we are going to learn Selenium IDE and see what are the drawbacks of Selenium IDE. Later on, we can go with Selenium WebDriver. What are the things which are there in RC are covered in WebDriver. So that directly after finishing the Selenium IDE, we can jump to Selenium. After finishing Selenium IDE, we can jump to Selenium WebDriver. Okay, that is what we are, tomorrow we can complete the Selenium IDE. It's not a big topic, it's a small topic only. We can just install Selenium IDE and see how that Selenium IDE works and what are the drawbacks with Selenium IDE. That's it. Okay, that's all about our today's class. As I said, today I will be taking only 1 hour of class, today and tomorrow. Going further from Friday onwards, we'll start full classes, that is 1.5 hour of classes. And very important classes also, first for 1 or 2 days. And take one more interview question also. How many element locators are there and what are they? That is the second interview question. You didn't learn about that properly. You know how many element locators are there, but you don't know what are those. That we'll see in tomorrow's class. How many element locators are there and what are they? Today you don't have any homework. From tomorrow onwards, I will give you regular homeworks also to you. What to do and what not to do, everything. That's all about today's class. Thank you.